This season on Scotty Survivor Lost in Time, 18 Carnegie Mellon students set out on the adventure of a lifetime on our first fully in-person season. They face grueling challenges. Innovative new twists, and we're forced to adapt every step of the way.
We are switching time!
Six people that complete the challenge in the fastest amount of time will earn their merge buff.
The only thing that will be revealed at the tribal council is the person who is going home. There will be no vote count.
Oh my god.
You will have 4 minutes to talk individually to each person in the cast one-on-one. After you talk with them, you won't see them again until after the votes have been cast.
And as if that wasn't enough, they were tormented by a contestant who shook up the game not even 48 hours after its start, the Puppet Master.
Freaking Puppet Master! Why are you doing this to us?
This silly but strategic pseudonym led to some of the most unique gameplay and wild season College Survivor has ever seen.
It was day two. I had an idol that wasn't mine. I had to do something with it. It was entertaining. I had a lot of fun. I'm sorry for what happened.
With every single cast member playing aggressively from the start, 13 castaways fell short on their quest to glory. Now, only 5 remain to clinch the title of Sole Survivor and to be the winner of Lost in Time. Valen came into the game with little knowledge of Survivor. After she was blindsided by her tribe mates to allegedly keep her in during her first tribal council, she stepped up her game and made crucial connections with some of the game's strongest players.
I need to make some alliance somewhere, because the reason why I was on the chopping block, or I believe I was on the chopping block, was because I hadn't established any real relationships in this first week.
Using her bond with Ethan and the premise that she'd be willing to flip on her Zaman original tribe later on, she was able to place herself in a strong position throughout the game where everyone depended on her vote. Gaining information about the Puppet Master's identity, Valen was able to expose Abby as the Puppet Master, setting the pace for Ethan to flip and the entire merge to explode.
I figured you out, and now I'm voting you out.
Having no votes against her in the entire merge, she sits in a position where everyone wants her in their final 3 plans. Despite having a strong social game, her sights have been set on adding strategic plays to her resume to complement her tight bonds.
I do think I edge her out a little bit more with like plays and like being on the correct side of voting, I guess.
Can she add enough to her resume and use her strong social game to earn the respect of the jury and win the title? Nadia came into the game with a fiery competitive spirit and a hunger for the win. Having bought multiple fake idols, she was able to acquire the Zaman Hidden Immunity idol after making contact with the Puppet Master, dubbing herself the Master Puppet Master.
I also named myself the Master Puppet Master, just to troll this guy a little bit, right?
Looking to stir up the game, Nadia placed a fake idol to evade suspicion of her having the real idol, leading the first blindside against Lauren. After her game was blown up by the realization of her secret friendship with Tina, the cast discovering she hid a fake idol and being Abby's scapegoat as the Puppet Master, Nadia has worked tirelessly to regain her trust in the game.
I keep telling her, I try to reason with her, and telling her how it doesn't make any sense that I'm Puppet Master.
By laying low and remaining loyal to her alliances, Nadia has avoided close elimination time and time again, despite her massive target.
The 11th person voted out of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time, and the 4th member of our jury, Vivian.
With a strong competition prowess and a determination to reach the end, can Nadia defeat the odds to come out on top? As a big fan of the game, Henry's strategy at the beginning was to lay low and not make any waves. Hiding himself behind his tribe's biggest targets in Ayal and Parker, no one even batted an eye at Henry prior to the merge.
Parker actually made a big impression on me. I didn't know him, but he recognized me. Apparently we had a class.
Realizing he needed a strong resume to defeat his planned Final 3 in Nadia and Valen, Henry utilized the game's format and twists to take out some of the biggest power players in the season.
When better to start than when nobody knows it's you?
Having been in control for the last 4 merge votes, Henry sits in the final 5 with a strong resume, having dominated the post-merge.
I think I could win if it were Zaman Final 3.
Can Henry avoid getting seen as a threat to win the whole game and clinch the crown? Haley came into the game looking to make strong social bonds, forging imperative connections with the game's most influential players. When she was almost blindsided during a swap, it served as a wake-up call to improve her position. Having been in on some of the most crucial votes of the season, Haley placed herself in a position where she could hide behind her allies as shields, knowing she'd be protected even when her alliances were targeted.
I am afraid of all of my alliance members. I am.
Forming secret deals and friendships with almost everyone in the merge, Haley's social game has kept her from being voted out, despite her closest allies going one after another the entire merge and being up against a strong majority alliance. Although Haley has many allies in the jury, she has been looking to cut her biggest shield in Abby to make her winning move of the game.
Abby is not a permanent player.
Can she take out her perceived biggest competitor and most trusted ally in Abby to earn the jury's approval? Abby is one of the most distinctive College Survivor players in history. Not 2 days after saying she had no lying ability, she created the character of the Puppet Master to have fun with the game. She also wanted to gain information on her fellow players after finding the Zaman idol.
This is Survivor. Why not have some fun? And that's what I did.
Her knowledge as the Puppet Master allowed her to make one of the game's biggest moves, blindsiding the Godfather Aeol, rattling the rest of the competitors for weeks to come.
You mess with the Godslayer, you get slain.
But as her game began to crumble when she revealed her secret friendship with Vivian to Ethan and the rest of the cast discovered she was the Puppet Master, Abby was forced to reevaluate her game. She laid low and used the argument that she would be easy to get rid of later and would never be able to make the final three as one of the game's biggest targets with little competition prowess. Her reputation as the Puppet Master, having touched every single idol in the game, kept her from being seriously targeted week after week. Having avoided elimination up until her first challenge win in the final six, Abby sits in the final five with an idol and an absolute hunger to make it to the end.
I mean, now I've just got to get people to take me to the final three, or I just need to win the challenge.
While not a single person wants her in the final three, can Abby continue her massive underdog arc, defend her game to the jury, and win as one of the season's most influential players? 18 players started this journey, 5 are left. Having fought every step of the way, they all have their own individual story as to why they should be the sole survivor of Lost in Time. With extremely strong players left in the game, it's truly anybody's to win. This is where it all goes down. This is where it comes to a close. Who will win the coveted title of sole survivor? The epic finale of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time starts now.
Final five, which is crazy. Guys, I'm in the final five.
I'm astounded that it went right for us. Finally something.
All went according to plan. Nikhil got voted out. I was very relieved after.
I honestly thought that they were maybe just gonna both vote for Haley because Henry had said something like, oh, Haley's gonna take Abby to the end, or like Haley's gonna get jury votes because she has a bunch of friends.
I immediately went and hugged Abby, which probably, I mean, it's not like a surprise, like that we're, you know, she's like the person I'm closest to right now. But yeah, it's just kind of funny how like, how not subtle we are about it at all.
Vote to Nikhil went as planned. And so he got voted out.
It was his time. I say that like he's like a a like one of those like pets you have since you're like 3 and now they're like 18 and like you've just been waiting for them to like pop off.
It had to happen. I know Ben, like he was in my final plans for a really long time, probably up until like before me making that decision that we should probably put him out, so sorry.
He dug himself a grave, honestly. I mean, we've seen it happen before where someone makes a stupid decision and it comes back and bites them later, and gets them voted out.
Final Six Tribal, I think coming in, I had a lot of different names in my head and a lot of different strategies going forward. And I really wanted, I low-key wanted Nikhil to still be in this because then I could potentially flip on Henry next week.
Nadia is clearly upset. Nadia is very clearly upset. I think she's mad at Valen.
I knew coming in that they were gonna vote Haley and that I just wasn't gonna win on a Nikhil vote, but I still voted with Nikhil just so I could hopefully get his vote if I make it to the final three, and that I technically did not blindside him.
I told her like 15 minutes before Tribal that it was Valen's idea, not mine, and that if I didn't go for Nikhil, we'd have to go to Rocks. That is true.
I've been thinking it over though. Honestly, it's scary for Abby to be in the final four. So in this way, we can get Abby out next week and I'm completely fine with that. Maybe in the end, me, Haley, and Valen can flip on Henry together and that would be the final three.
I'm really, really worried about Nadia wanting Negan next week. I mean, hopefully she'll like gun for Valen instead and then we can all get her.
I had promised Henry that I wasn't gonna vote for him if he voted with us this past vote to get Nikhil out. Did not pinky promise. Henry pinky promised that he would vote Nikhil and then he did, which is interesting. finally, Henry's actually voted with us.
Abby said that I'm, along with Haley, one of the few people likely to actually bring her along to the final three, just because I actually stand a chance of beating her.
I don't want Henry at the end because I feel like he would have a really strong case. So it's a trade-off. And if I'm banking on winning the Final Four challenge anyway, do I really want Henry there? I don't know. I would feel bad breaking that promise, but I've broken a worse promise with Ethan before.
And so for that reason, she said that she'd be down to go Nadia next time, if Nadia is an option.
He says, I hope you're not catfishing me about next vote. And then I go, I truly think the only way I make Final Three is either win the challenge or you and Haley are there at Final Four, so I'm keeping my options open.
The only way I'm going to be certainly in the Final Four is if I win. And I'm so nervous, my heart is going so fucking fast.
I never pinky promised that I would not vote him out. I said I would, and then I didn't.
I'm sorry, Nadia. I'm sorry we couldn't bring Nikhil further. But I'm planning to stay at this point.
Come on in, guys! Welcome to your Final Five Immunity Challenge. First things first, Abby, I'll take it back. This challenge is called Memory Lane, and here's how it works. Each part of this challenge has parts from another challenge you've already completed to complete this immunity challenge. The first part is from the domino challenge, where you will have to stack the dominoes and push them down from the start to end marks right below your chair. After that is complete, you will run over to the other side, where behind the stage there is a paper with the equation part of the challenge. You will be running around to find different things that will solve an equation like you did in that challenge. Once you're done with that, you can ask for a check. When you are complete, you will come back to here where you will solve the memory lane part of this challenge. Below your chair, there is a sheet with all of the important days in this game. Your job is to figure out what happened where, which challenge happened when, and who got voted out when. When you're done with that, you can ask for a check. When it's correct, you will run back and solve a 6x6 slide puzzle. The winner gets a spot in the final four. For immunity and a spot in the final four. Survivors ready, go.
And this challenge is on. Everybody unbagging their dominoes.
Oh,
God,
goddamn.
Everybody stacking their dominoes.
What else are we gonna be doing?
Henry, did you really say what else would we be doing?
Yeah, I mean, obviously we're stacking fucking dominoes.
There's some, the tensions are high today.
Henry, down to his last few dominoes.
Can I
Abby, down to her last few dominoes. Will it fall? All right, Abby gonna give it a go. Abby puts down her dominoes. She's
Where am starting. I going? Fuck.
Yeah.
Henry's done. Haley's done. Everybody's going.
Fuck.
Oh, come on.
Abby running back already.
Nadia and Valen still working on the dominoes.
Abby running back.
Ah!
Abby running back.
Bailey and Henry counting.
If they knock over my dominoes, I'm gonna.
Henry gonna give it a try. Haley going back.
Like the math, you guys.
Abby coming back.
What is fucking 8 and 5? Is my answer correct?
Shane.
My answer correct?
Incorrect.
Okay.
Music major, I can do math. What the frick is that? 8 times 6, I think it's 54.
Haley's struggling to do math.
I don't care, remember, this is so embarrassing.
Henry, you're actually correct.
Oh, it's correct over there?
Yeah, I made it to your room.
Wait, 8, 6 times 7, 42. Right? 42. Don't cut that.
Cover my paper! Hide my paper!
Abby and Haley solving the equation. Abby struggling to do math. The PhD student.
No!
Is there something
to
write on?
No!
Check. 57,120.
Incorrect.
Is this right?
Incorrect.
That's correct.
Oh, incorrect, yes.
That's correct.
Where am I going?
Poker chips and dice. Let's check that.
Haley's still counting. Abby's still working on everything.
What the hell is the third challenge?
Nadia!
Oh my god!
I don't remember the names of the challenges. Can you describe them to me?
Start counting backwards.
Oh my gosh, I timesed all of them.
My hands are like shaking with like how bad this is going.
Correct!
Now what do I do?
Go to the memory lane.
Okay.
Bailey off to the memory lane.
Ooh, something's happened here. That's wrong.
No! Ah! Where'd I go? Wait, so, day one, wait, what does that mean?
Abby making some progress. Let's start. And Henry is correct, moving on to the flag puzzle.
Yes! Let's go, over here.
Oh my god.
Maybe it was that, and then...
Abby down to the last couple. Okay.
No, I drew another one.
Check.
Zoe, 299?
Yeah. And Nadia,
Fucking remember me, Nadia.
Correct! Abby running to the final part of the challenge.
I am? Okay.
I'm gonna have a slight lead over Abby.
Oh, Abby?
No! Shut up!
Henry's got his first throw down. Almost.
Do I see a
row? Oh my god, of course she does!
Oh, I'm bad at counting!
Can I brute force this and rebuild it? Does that count?
Henry's got some of it. Abby's got a row and a half.
Come on, you already know that I haven't won a challenge yet and I deserve one. Come on!
Do you think you can do this?
Wait, why are you asking me that? I think I may have just figured out one of the algorithms.
He's just saying that.
Check.
Alright,
Nadia, that's the first check.
That fucking little leprechaun, I swear to God.
And that is correct. Nadia moving on to the slide puzzle.
Henry is making progress.
No, I'm not.
Nadia is starting on the slide puzzle.
Abby down to her last two rows.
And Abby wins individual immunity and a spot in the final four. Second challenge win in a row!
What the fuck?
Congratulations, Abby. Come and get it once again. Immunity is yours and a spot in the final four. The rest of you, one of you will be the 14th member voted out of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time and the 7th member of our jury. Who that will be, we'll find out in due time. Good night.
I won two challenges in a row, so nice.
This is frustrating that Abby won immunity. That means we can't vote her out, and my strategy is now no longer a strategy. So I need to think about how I want to get to the final grade at this point.
Abby won the last challenge, really not gassed about that. But it came down to a slide puzzle, and slide puzzle is the kind of thing where you either know how to solve it or you don't. And I didn't, and she did.
I did feel bad that I'd won, which is like silly to say. I mean, look, he didn't research slide puzzles before day one. I researched slide puzzles before day one.
Stupid dominoes, man. Stupid dominoes. I never really played with dominoes as a kid, and of course that'd be my downfall, and slide puzzle. Never done a slide puzzle in my life, and of course that shows up as well here in Survivor. I really should have done my research before this game, instead of buying fake idols on Amazon.
Abby wins. Again. And she was like the worst possible... Okay, I think she was the worst possible person to win immunity.
I still haven't won one, and I'm so pissed because I know I'm capable of winning. I'm a freaking athlete here and competitor, and I can't win these stupid challenges.
Abby won individual immunity, which actually was, if I'm not mistaken, a very good thing for me.
It's a little bit funny because I have been holding out playing, I don't know where it went. I've lost the idol. I have been holding out playing this idol for so many votes, and like I haven't had to play it on myself, obviously, because I'm still here, but I've been holding out playing it for so long, now I don't even need it. It's like quite funny.
This is the last round in which she can play an idol, which she has the merge idol, and everyone knows it at this point. She's told everyone. I've known for like maybe a week or less, probably. But Abby's gonna play her idol on me.
I've already told Haley I'm gonna play the idol on her because I was like, oh, I owe it to you, which is like kind of true because she stuck with me like the whole time. And I literally cried last time about the possibility of not playing it for her because she's been like really nice to me and has stuck with me.
I know she has the merge idol. Like I know she has it. And so now she has immunity. She's definitely giving that idol to Haley. And so, someone from Zaman is going home.
It's inevitable that it's either Henry or Nadia.
And it's going to be between Henry and Nadia. I want it to be Nadia. Like, I'd rather have Henry here stay.
Because it seems like for a while, a lot of people were like, Abby's just like a shoe-in if she gets to the final three. Like, she's definitely gonna win. And I don't really think that, especially if Henry's there. It's definitely not like a, definitely gonna go to me. But if Henry thinks that it's definitely gonna go to me, then there's no reason that he would take me to the final three.
I had a stronger connection with Henry, and I'd rather have Henry here than Nadia at this point. So all I have to say is rest in peace, Zaman.
I don't think Abby and Haley wanna keep me around because I think I'm probably a bigger threat than Nadia. So, yeah, I mean, there's not much, kind of no wiggle room at this point. I have no power, there's nobody to plead my case to.
Henry's word is fuck, it's gonna be him, and I'm trying to make sure that Nadia, or that Haley and Abby vote with me, and Henry.
I think it's less impressive to have played a good pre-merge and, like, totally kind of given up. Not given up, but, like, totally, like...
taking a backseat.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Purposefully taking a backseat in post-merge versus someone who's, like, actually started playing post-merge, which is Henry.
This whole time, I've really just been flip-flopping, just back and forth, like, thinking who is the person that I would like to go home, and who is it that I feel like I would have more of a chance of beating in final three?
I've been thinking that Henry has been a threat ever since stuff started going down.
Mm-hmm.
And I've honestly been wanting him out for like a while. I've been throwing his name out for a couple rounds.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's been like him or me.
I think that they're gonna vote Henry out. So I really hope that happens. I hate this. I hate this so much. I just wanna make it to the end.
I like you all so much, and
yeah, I know.
Now I feel like I'm coming from a weird power position. No, like, yeah, it sucks because we've all become so close, and like, I just, yeah, whatever happens, it's like not something we like want to do.
All this time I've been thinking Nadia, but ever since merge, I've been thinking Henry. And I mean, I guess it just goes to show that pre-merge, Nadia played harder, and post-merge, Henry played harder.
I just have to hope that they want me in final four, which is unlikely, so yeah. I don't know, it feels like the end of my game.
Henry goes, I just highly doubt either of you really want me there at four. And then he said, it's just fucked up, it's on my birthday. Which is funny because the tribal was supposed to be on Henry's birthday. Now it is 2 days after his birthday because his birthday is yesterday and tribal's tomorrow. So I feel less bad voting him out.
Hey, I hope I stick around. I would love a crack at this challenge. I feel like if I make it to final four, I have a really good shot at final three.
Henry goes, I def like you more than Nadia does, lol, which is true. And I was like, it's not hard to like me more than Nadia does. That girl fucking hates me. And then he was like, let's get her then. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. And then I was like, let's vote Valen, lol, as a joke. And then he was like, she honestly has a good pitch, like at the end. Never a target, friends with everybody, complete sleeper game. Also true. Then here's where he's really trying to butter me up. Okay, we're getting to the good part now. He goes, after like 5 minutes, it's like a 5 minute interval, like he double texts me and he goes, I want the final showdown at final jury. And I'm like, lol, what do you mean? He says, like a final three worthy of the season. Haha, maybe that's crazy. Henry, come on. I said, that's fair though. He said, if you're on that wave, I would love to see you in final three. Like really leave it to the jury. Okay. Then again, like a 5 minute interval when I don't respond. And then he goes, haha, IDK, every time we talk, my hopes get high. He's really trying. And it's like working a little bit. Like I do feel bad.
Abby and Haley have been up in the air and I have no idea where they stand, but I think right now Abby's gonna vote Henry and Haley is going to vote Nadia. And things should work out because if me and Henry vote Nadia, then, and Haley does too, then it's Nadia.
I mean, I don't want you to go. So I've accepted the fact that eventually I might have to vote out Henry. I want him to continue with me as much as he can.
I'm worried that Haley's going to flip on me and vote Henry. We called earlier today, like 20 minutes ago or so, and she's concerned that, like, if, you know, in the final four challenge, if, or like in the final four tribal or whatever, if Abby wins immunity and it's a, like, if I were to vote with them to vote out Henry, if I would tie it.
I know that I said that I wanted to vote out Nadia, but my main concern is for if we do, next round, if Abby wins individual immunity, will you vote with me and Abby, or are you going to vote with Henry?
Though she flips on me now, and they vote out Henry, because then she says, like, I'm more concerned if you were to tie it, if Henry was still in the game, than with Nadia. But if she flips and votes Henry out today, I'm tying it with Nadia.
If next round, Abby wins immunity, if Nadia is still in, will Valen vote with us and vote out Nadia? Or will they both vote me and force a tie?
I honestly do think he does make a good point about, like, you want a final three that's, like, worthy of the season. And, like, voting off Henry and just having, Nadia, Valen, or Haley, who've all played, like, similar sleeper games a little bit, like, have not been flashy or, like, tried to convince most people of anything, that sort of thing. It's like, oh god. It's, like, less satisfying to win against.
I don't know what to do anymore. I just hope I don't get voted out in the final five.
If I go home today, I know why, and it makes sense. And it's, I'm getting votes from people I know and like.
Let's start with the obvious. Abby, you won individual immunity yet again, earning your spot in the final four. What's the feeling going into the final four challenge after this
fight? Going into the final four challenge? I feel like a bit of an asshole for winning the last challenge. Honestly. It's down to winning this next one for me if I have a chance of making it.
Not yet. Let's not avoid the obvious. There's three OG Zamans here today. How does Abby winning the challenge impact your vote today?
I mean, we know he has
the
idol.
Yeah,
we know that. We know he's gonna give it to Haley. So at this point, it's obvious that it's gonna be me or Henry.
Henry, how are you feeling knowing that it's, according to Nadia, you're her? Nadia said that Abby's giving you her idol. What is going through your mind about how you're making the decision today?
It feels good to be safe. But at the same time, it's pretty clear that I'm right in the middle and it's my decision who goes home today. And I don't know. I really don't know how to feel about it. I don't like it at all. It's not comfortable. And yeah.
Valen, this tribe, but we've been talking about two people that have been on your original tribe since day one. How are you feeling about the fact that you allegedly have to vote one of them out today?
Very sad.
All right.
It's a sad day for Zamal.
Well, let's vote. Abby, you're up first. You cannot vote for Abby. Everybody else is fair game.
At least it's not your birthday.
Good game.
I have one thing to say. Fuck you, Tina.
I have the vote. If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and would like to play one, now is the last and final time to do so.
Yeah, I mean, I can't. Shocker.
An idol?
Oh,
an idol?
Are you sure it's not one of the obvious things?
I know. I'm gonna play it for. I'm gonna play for him.
This is a hidden immunity idol. The rules of Survivor state that if a hidden immunity idol is played, all votes against that person will not count, and the person with the next highest vote will be voted out. All votes for Haley will not count. Once the vote is read, the decision is final, and the person voted out will be asked to leave the private class area immediately. I'll read the votes. First vote. Henry, that's one vote, Henry. Nadia, that's one vote, Henry. One vote, Nadia. Three votes left. Next vote. Nadia, that's two votes Henry, two votes Nadia, one vote left. And the 14th person voted out of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time, and the 7th member of our jury, Henry. Henry, that's three, today that's enough. Please bring me your report. Henry, the tribe has spoken. Time for you to go. One more challenge. One more tribal. Who will make it to the final three? You'll find out shortly.
Can't be mad. Really can't be mad. I didn't think I'd make it this far. I'm happy I did. I mean, just thinking about the experience as a whole, like I, just like the cast alone, I said this in my confessional, but like, I don't think I knew 17 people here. So like, my circle has probably tripled or quadrupled, which is so great. I mean, I feel like I played the game I wanted to play. I made some good friendships. I wish I'd won a challenge at some point, but yeah, I don't know. Can't really complain.
Well, my allies from the beginning, Henry got voted out, but you know, it was either me or him today, and I'm just glad that wasn't me.
I was about to change my mind, which I was about to, and then I tapped Abby on the shoulder. I was like, Abby, I want to vote Nadia, and she was like, and I was like, and right before, I just decided, okay, I'm going to stick with Henry. And I know that I made that video right before saying, it's Nadia, and I want it to be Nadia, and I don't want to be convinced otherwise. Well, I was convinced otherwise.
I think Henry genuinely thought he had a shot. I genuinely thought Henry would have a shot if he made it to final three.
All I could think about was the fact that, like, if Henry made it another round, how him and Valen could possibly vote together and vote me and force a tie and then go to fire making.
Told her if it comes to that, like, don't worry, I'll do what I have to do. I just want to give Henry the chance because he could win the challenge and not Abby. And that's basically what I told Haley, but she decided to vote out Henry.
And me losing to the tiebreaker challenge, if Abby won individual immunity.
I'm really sad about it. I already talked about how sad I was about it. But basically, I'm thinking rather than giving Haley an easy, easy way into the final three, I'm going to make her work for it. And I think I'm going to tie the vote anyways, even though it's Nadia. And see if it's Nadia or Haley. At this point, I think I edge out both of them. So for me, I'll see what happens. I think it's just me being petty, honestly.
I'm so close. I can feel it. I haven't won a single individual immunity challenge since the merge, and I am so pissed off and furious because I haven't won one. I've been so close so many times. I don't want it to happen today, and it's not gonna happen.
We'll see. Hopefully I win it. And we just vote out Abby.
And I absolutely don't want Abby to win more than anything, because if she wins, I've lost Survivor. And I think all of us have lost Survivor.
I have to win this or they're gonna yeet me so hard. It's really, it all comes down to this challenge. It's like, this is where I win or lose.
People like to call me Clutch, and you know, I gotta live up to my name today, because I am Clutch, and I got my red mask for a reason. I'm out for blood. And I got a channel, that inner Tiger Woods Sunday Red.
Wish me luck. Let's fucking go. I am so nervous. I'm gonna poo myself.
It's time to go big or go home.
And I'm not ready to go home.
Let's go!
Let's go!
We finally made it to our final immunity challenge. For the final time, Abby, I'll take it back. Immunity is once again back up for grabs. Here's how today's challenge works. The challenge is called Lost in Trifecta. It will be a three-part immunity challenge, with the person who places lowest being eliminated in each round. I'll start off by explaining the first round now. After each round concludes, I'll then explain how the next round works. In front of all of you, you see that you have a series of dice. You also have a place to stack those dice. Using just your hands, you're gonna have to stack the dice on top of each other until you create a tower of 15. The final person to complete their dice, or not complete their dice stack, will be eliminated from part one, with the other three moving on to part two. There are no questions, we already have our spots. Let's get started for the final and most important immunity challenge of the season. For the final time, survivors ready! And go! One die remaining, one die.
I need you to shut the fuck up.
One, two, three. Abby moves on to part two. We have our first finisher. Nadia versus Haley. Haley down to three, Nadia down to three. We're getting extremely close. Nadia's down to two. And Haley's small. Nadia trying to get the friction off.
Time. 3 minutes left.
Nadia
just sitting there, not wanting.
If we reach 15 minutes, whoever has the tallest stack remaining will be moving on. So Nadia's taking the approach that she's gonna let hers be, assuming that Haley won't be able to reach that high in the next 3 minutes.
2 minutes remaining, will Haley get
epic Nadia? Haley making quick progress. Haley getting dice after dice on the tower. Coming up on a minute remaining, 1 minute remaining, and Haley's dice stack falls. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Haley's dice stack falls, meaning that Nadia moves on to the next round. We have our top three. The second part is called color confusion, and here's how it works. You have 8 packets of M&Ms in front of you. Please sponsor us. You will have to sort those colors into discrete groups. Call me over after you're done. First 2 to finish, win. We just had a long challenge to start off. Now this is gonna go by in a blink of an eye. Survivors ready? And go!
Abby's M&Ms go flying. Got 2 different approaches. Now you're trying to sort them as she goes. Everybody else is trying to open as many as possible. Haley cheering on everyone, trying to really work that social game. Nadia making quick progress sorting as she goes. Abby's now got everything out of the bag. Looking at Val, and Val's got a few more bags left over.
No, I only got one. Done.
And Abby's the first to finish. Abby is all good, on to the next round.
That leaves just Valen and Nadia. Nadia's got 1 packet left over. Valen's trying to sort all the ones that are already out. It's extremely close.
Good.
Nadia moves on!
No, all the same color.
Oh, Nadia does not move on. No. Nadia does not have all the same color. Valen called first. Valen's blues were. Valen was not moved before Nadia was done.
She's got a blue over there.
That is actually fair. Nadia's are not all together on that end.
I was done.
It was Nadia first.
No, she's not done. Valen is the first to finish. Nadia missed one of the blues on the side edge, meaning that Nadia is eliminated in round 2. With that, we're down to our final 2 in the final immunity challenge of season 2. This is what you covet, the final immunity necklace, a guaranteed spot in the final 3, and the opportunity to explain your case to the jury. In front of you, the infamous tree puzzle, eliminated people in season 1, gonna eliminate somebody again in season 2. Survivors ready? On your marks, go!
Valen looking for her first piece. Abby gets another piece in. Valen's still looking. Abby's making a lot of progress. Remember in season 1, somebody jumped out to a huge lead and then lost that lead a little quickly. We'll see if that happens again in season 2.
Let's hope not.
Abby looking puzzled.
Feeling smart about this. Either of my girls.
Well, flipping around some pieces. We have 2 different strategies going on right here. Abby's trying to group things into larger ones before putting them on. Whereas Val's trying to group them on. I think Val's got none on the tree.
I've got a couple pieces on. Thank you very much.
Take that back.
Yeah. Not many, but I got some.
Abby gets another piece in. Abby's making pretty quick progress compared to how we've seen the puzzle solved in the past. Abby gets another piece in. Abby making a lot of progress. It's heating up now. Abby getting another piece in.
I'm out. Oh my god, second lane.
Fallon getting a lot of views in it all at once.
Happy Fallon.
Abby's getting one more piece in. Fallon getting yet another piece. Fallon's beginning to pick up speed. Abby's got only three more pieces left. She's stuck.
Hope I am.
Breaking news, Abby is indeed stuck, confirmed by our sources. Abby is almost there, two pieces remaining. Abby, one piece remaining.
Where does this go?
Fallon's getting piece after piece, it's getting tight. Abby with the final piece, Abby! After one of the most intense challenges of the season, third time in a row, you've guaranteed yourself a spot in the final three. Come on up here. You've won immunity yet again. To the rest of you, one of you will become the final juror of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time. Let's see what will happen to make sure that's not going to be you. Best of luck. Gather your stuff. Head on out.
Said multiple times that you and Haley have split votes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nadia's trying to get me to vote for you.
Okay.
Her argument is that the jury is going to split votes between me and you because they like us both. They will vote for each other.
Well, that's what I meant.
That, they won't, I think, can't, that's
vote
a given.
It's a given.
Yes.
So it's literally just us two.
Yes.
Okay. So there's nothing else I can do at this point.
What are you gonna say?
Fallon and Nadia. Wait, hold on. I can convince Nadia to throw the vote on Fallon. If I say that I convinced you to vote on Fallon, I sort of made kind of a good case that we could make it work.
Kami told me she was gonna convince you to vote me.
Really? Haley told me that they're gonna vote me. I won't.
That they're gonna vote me?
Yeah.
Abby just told me she's not voting for me.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know. Will you promise you're not gonna vote for me?
I promise you. I'll pay your balls again. I promise you. So who's she gonna vote for? Is she voting me?
Yeah.
Are you voting Haley then?
With you. Oh my god.
It's your choice.
Me? Oh my god, I don't like making decisions.
You
remember this.
If
Haley's already has doubts or thoughts that you had already brought up that you're gonna vote for her,
yeah.
Vote for
I will vote for Haley.
I will vote for Nadia.
Okay.
Should we confirm with them who they're voting for, or we just a given that?
Well, they can't vote for each other.
One on me, one on Balan, two on Nadia. We'll vote Nadia, but we tell Nadia that I convinced you to vote out Balan.
If Abby votes for me, and then Haley goes for you, and Haley's out.
We will now welcome in the members of our jury, Runjan, Ricky, Ethan, Vivian, Henry voted out at the last tribal council. Let's talk about the obvious. Abby, you won your third individual immunity challenge in a row tonight, guaranteeing yourself a spot in the final three. How are you feeling knowing that no matter what happens tonight, you get a chance to plead your case to the jury?
What the hell am I supposed to say? It feels awful, man. No, it feels great. I'm really happy. I didn't think I was gonna get this far at all. Like, I'm as astounded as the rest of you guys, but I'm here at all. So I'm just like, yeah, I feel very lucky.
Haley, it's no secret that Abby has been a target since the beginning of Merge. How does her being off the table tonight affect the vote?
I mean, in my brain, it's sort of like that one task that, like, done. Like, you just need to, like, put that, like, last sock in the drawer or something. And and you just like keep putting it off and putting it off and putting it off. And then your mom just like puts it in the drawer for you and you're like, I was gonna do that. Like
Abby absolutely deserves to be here. It's great. It's both like how but also like dead, you know?
Valen, we're at the point where only you, Haley, and Nadia can be voted tonight. What's going into tonight's vote?
So many things. I mean, I guess at this point, for the final three, you just have to think about how people have played in general and your personal relationship with the people who are still left to vote for.
Nadia, how are you measuring who you can beat in the final tribal, who you want to be with you, and who should be the one to go home?
I mean, at this point, like, I'm trembling right now. Like, I just want to make it there first. Like, at this point, I know I'm probably one of the ones that are on the chopping block, and I'm just thinking of surviving and getting to the final three.
All right. With that, it's time to vote. You cannot vote for Abby. Abby, you're up first.
Can you imagine if this doesn't work?
I have no words. I hope miraculously it's you. If not, let's go to a fucking showdown.
I think you promised two different people.
I fucking hate this thing. Well,
I'll go tally the votes. I have the votes. Once the votes are read, the decision is final, and the person voted out will be asked to leave the tribal council area immediately. I'll read the votes. First vote, Nadia.
One vote, Nadia.
Next vote, Haley. That's one vote, Nadia, one vote, Haley, two votes left. Haley. That's two votes, Haley. One vote, Nadia. One vote left. And the 15th person voted out of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time, and the 8th and final member of our jury, will be decided in a firebreaker challenge. Because this vote is for Nadia.
We're going to a tiebreaker challenge.
This tiebreaker challenge is called 21 Flags, and here's how it works. There are 21 flags on the table. Your goal is to pick up the 21st flag each round. Each time, you can pick up one, two, or three flags. Then the next person will pick one, two, or three flags. The person who picks the 21st flag will win the round. We'll do best of three. The person who wins the most rounds will get a spot in the final three. The loser will be the 8th and final member of the jury. The third round, the person who goes first will be picked by who picks up the most flags cumulatively. By random draw, Haley will go first. Haley takes one, Nadia's turn. Nadia takes one, Haley's turn. Haley takes two. Nadia takes three. Haley wins the first round. How many do each have? Round two, Nadia will go first. Nadia takes one. Haley takes three. Nadia takes three. Haley takes three. Not even hesitating. Going to the tiebreaker round. It all comes down to this. How many dice do you have? The rules stated that if there was a third round of this challenge, the person who had the most amount of dice would go first. Since they both have 21 dice over two rounds, we are going to roll a dice to see who goes first. Haley will be evens, Nadia will be odds. It is odds, Nadia will go first. It all comes down to this. Nadia picks up one. Haley picks up three. Nadia rearranging the dice. There are 10 left.
I don't know anymore.
Nadia takes one dice. Haley as the winner of the challenge. Woo! Haley has earned her spot in the final three. Nadia, I'm sorry, tonight you have been eliminated. Please bring your torch. Nadia, tonight the game has spoken.
It really has.
It's time for you to go. The three of you. Congratulations. You have now made it as far as you possibly can in this game. On Wednesday, the power shifts to the jury, where they will be choosing one of the three of you to become the second winner of Scotty's Survivor. If tonight's tribal shows you anything, it shows you that the women run this game. And get ready to plead your case for the jury on Wednesday night at Final Tribal Council. Go for it.
Of course I lose to another logical puzzle shit thing. It's fine, you know, I knew I fucked up during that round once I got to like 8, I think. So, you know, gave it my all this season. And hopefully I can see you on All-Stars. Prod. All-Stars. Please. Yeah. Thanks, guys.
we're in the final three. Never expected to get here at all, so I have no idea what I'm saying at Final Tribal. I have a feeling I am slightly resented in the jury, because for all intents and purposes, I should not have made it here. And there are people sitting on the jury who I think believe they should have made it here. Instead of me.
Now I feel like I've really earned it. Like, I feel like I've earned it. And that's really what I wanted. I wanted to feel like that. I don't know if that's better. I wanted to feel like I earned it. And I feel like I earned it tonight. And if I don't win, I'm proud of what I did tonight.
I was almost voted out in my first tribal, but now it's time to make it to the last one. I really want to make it to the top three and fucking win this whole thing. So when no one expected it, and it would be a great fuck you to everyone who didn't believe in me. I guess for like the beginning of this whole game where I was probably on the bottom with Zaman and everything like that, and no one thought that I would make this far. But look, I have, and I think I've done a good fucking job of getting here and using my strength to get me here.
For the last time, we will welcome in the members of our jury. Runjin, Ricky, Ethan, Vivian, Xavier, Nikhil, Henry, and Nadia voted out at the last tribal council. Welcome to the final tribal council of Scotty Survivor Lost in Time. Today, you will be listening to the games of Haley, Valen, and Abby, where they will try to convince you that they should be the sole survivor of this season. For the past 71 days, they've outwitted, outplayed, and outlasted you. And now, their fate is in your hands. We will start with an opening statement from each finalist. They will have 8 minutes to plead their case to you. When they are done, you will have the opportunity to ask them questions. There will be a 5 to 8 minute cap. We will start with Runjin, and we will end with Nadia. Afterwards, we will vote, and the winner will be revealed. The order was determined by random draw. The order is Haley, Valen, and Abby. Haley, you are up first.
Okay, so I'm gonna keep my opening statement short and sweet today. But first of all, I'd like to say congratulations to Abby and Valen. From the bottom of my heart, I'm so honored to be sitting here in Final Three with both of you. And I'm so proud of us and the games that we all played together. And to the jury tonight, I want to say that y'all have the difficult decision of choosing who you want to represent as the winner of our season of Scotty Survivor. And we all hold this game very near and dear to our hearts for a multitude of individual reasons. And for that, I want to say and acknowledge that tonight's decision is both extremely important, but also very, very personal. And if I could emphasize one thing, it's that I played this game so that if I ever got voted out, I would leave having no regrets. And the reason that I sit here tonight in Final Three with such confidence is because I have, although I know that I did not play a perfect game, I sit here knowing that I have absolutely no regrets about the game that I played. And for that, I really hope that you keep that in mind as you make your decisions tonight.
As much as it was stressful, I had a blast playing.
And I know I've made some long-lasting friendships with everyone here, and so I'm just excited to what comes next. And I really am proud to be sitting here with Haley and with Abby. You guys should be proud of yourselves. I mean, we played a really good game, and that's why we're here. So I just, thanks, first of all. And I kind of came into this game with zero expectations for myself. I have still yet to see an episode of Survivor, so I really played this game with my own wits, my own knowledge. I kind of learned on the fly, and that was kind of evident in my first tribal. I learned a lot from it, and I knew that I had to play to my strengths, and that was, you know, building strong relationships and good alliances. And I am someone who wants to make friends with like every single person, so that's kind of how I wanted to play and build strong relationships with people, because I knew that was going to be important from Merge. So during the Merge, I really made sure that I built strong relationships with a lot of different people, and that's what put me in such a strong position when I was in the Merge. I know I at least had strong alliances and or a good relationship with every single person on that jury and with the two girls who are sitting next to me. And that's what kept me safe every single round. I did not receive a single vote in the Merge, and I did not need the protection of any idols or the use of any advantage. I really made it my way here because of my relationship with people and focusing on that. And although I was safe every round, I did go to the most tribals and survived all of them, which here I am in the last one. And although I was, you know, safe every round, I don't think I was just someone's vote every time. I wasn't safe in someone else's shadow. I really made sure that my voice was heard and that I influenced decisions, and that I was on the right side of most of all the votes too. And I really wanted to make sure that me and my allies made it as far as we could. And I've been trustworthy, reliable. You guys did say you would trust me with your life during such a subject. So I really used that to my advantage to influence people, because I knew people believed in the direction I was going in, and it's how I won a challenge. And I just knew that I had to play smartly, and I didn't have to make big noisy moves that would, you know, create a target on my back or betray any allies, because I knew just by playing smartly and with my strong relationships that I would get to the position that I am now. And knowing that I was safe almost every round, and I knew I probably had a good chance of making the top three, it allowed me to not have to scramble at any point, and it allowed me to really, you know, think ahead and plan ahead. And yeah, I really think I've just been a fair, reliable player, and I think I should win just because I didn't have to make big noisy moves to make it this far. And I really used my own knowledge and my own wits to make it this far. So again, just thanks also. But yeah.
No!
Not right before your face.
Oh god, my notes.
I'm gonna start out how everyone started out. I mean, just congratulate you guys for both being here. You guys definitely deserve to be here, and I love playing this game with you, and you're lovely people, and I'm so glad to be sitting here with you guys today. Yeah, so I wanted to start with that. Congrats. I think it's not a secret that I played a very different game than these two. I think it has been said by some people, maybe this was like more of a thing to say early in the Merge, but like, if Abby gets to the end, she's gonna win.
I think I would be really stupid to come into this tribal thinking that way. I mean, you guys voted me the person you would at least like to see win, not 4 rounds ago.
So like, I'm not feeling overconfident. That being said,
I know I'm gonna have to fight for jury votes today. I just hope that you're gonna hear my case
and consider it. We all played an excellent game. We're all here, like, on our own merit, in our own way. So, anyway, wanted to preface with that. I have a lot to say, and I'm gonna cut it down because it's too much. You guys can ask me about stuff. You guys can ask me about anything you want, whatever. I just wanna say a couple things. Who would I be in this game if not for the Puppet Master? I feel like that needs to be addressed. I put a target on my back like day two in this game when I found an idol that I didn't know what to do with. I thought I would have some fun with it.
There was a point in this game where I thought that was like the stupidest shit I had ever done.
And like, why would I put a target on my back like that? Like, why would I go all out day two? Like, that was just unnecessary. I think actually,
you guys finding out that I was the puppet master was probably the best thing that happened to me in the merge.
I mean, I would have been gone so early on if you guys didn't think I had like six idols up my sleeve or that I was an easy target that you could vote out later on.
And you all know that that was my pitch the whole merge. I was like, look, keep me around for this vote. You can always vote me off later. Like, God knows I'm not gonna win the challenges. Little did you know. I mean, to be fair, I didn't know I was gonna win the challenges either, but I think like that pitch that you can always vote me off, I'm the biggest threat here, you can always vote me off later, that's what got me where I am today. I think I also want to address, like, I did not have the most stellar early merge. This freaking ambulance. Okay. I did not have the most stellar early merge. Is it coming back?
They're coming for you, Abby.
Because y'all are murdering these stitches, like.
I'm gonna say that sentence for the third time. I did not have the best early merge. I think we all know that. I mean, I had my closest ally voting off my other allies for two rounds. It was not like the greatest position to be in.
I think it's also like very easy to look at all my merge votes and think that I was sitting there getting blindsided every single time. I would like to draw attention to the fact that I had an idol at the end of this game that I didn't even need.
And I don't get in that position without knowing what was going on. Like, I didn't sit at every tribal council thinking that that vote was gonna go my way. In fact, I sat at a lot of them thinking that it was gonna go poorly. But I knew for all of them that I wasn't the one who was on the chopping block that round.
I didn't get, well, I probably got two votes in the dark round in the merge. Other than that, I didn't get any votes in this merge. That was probably due to that pitch I was talking about earlier. Like, you can keep me around until you have to vote me off.
It's because of this reputation that I've touched every idol in this game. Like, you guys, I knew that if anyone said that they were going to vote me, if anyone remotely hinted that they were going to vote me, I wasn't getting any votes that round. And so I knew not to play an idol because of that. To be fair, I did get skittish that one time. I did play it. But I held on to the second idol. I held on to that merge idol until the very end. I knew that I was safe every round. I was right every single time.
As someone coming into the merge with like the biggest target on my back, to get to the end with an idol unplayed, I think is impressive.
You guys can ask me anything you want about my game. I'm happy to answer. Thank you for listening.
And congrats to you guys.
I love each and every single one of you. I think we've all developed our own like friendships. And I know that like we're gonna continue being friends beyond this. With that said, I don't know if I want to hold back with these questions. I do want to make sure I'm asking what needs to be asked. But without further ado, I do want to start asking my questions. And my first question is to you, Valen. So in your speech, you mentioned something. You mentioned a lot about big, noisy moves. Is there someone you're particularly referring to when you were mentioning that in your speech?
I wasn't exactly referencing a specific person. It was more of the fact that I know people like expected that to be a way you play the game. And if I was playing too passively, people might have thought, why isn't she doing anything? And I really thought I didn't have to do any of that. And I know some people play, you know, big moves that unfortunately then, you know, put a target on their back later on. And like, that's a bunch of people, pre-merge, merge. And I didn't want a target on my back. I wanted to be safe, but play smartly.
Thank you for your answer. My next question, Haley, your name was unfortunately not brought up as much as the other two during roundtable. What do you think was your most underrated move or underrated behind the scenes play? Why do you think it was underrated? And what do you wish the jury knew about you that they might not have known at that point?
Well, I'd like to speak to the last of your questions right now. Something that is underrated about me. I can totally sit here and completely understand that my game may seem passive and may seem as though I was sort of, you know, people pleasing or doing what others wanted me to do. But I can sit here and say that I completely intentionally chose to play that way because that is how I got to Final 3 right here.
I mean, I chose to play that way from day one. You know, Abby and I hit it right off the bat. We went looking for that Dorit idol. You know, we found it. And the way I wanted to play the game was to first and foremost get people to trust me. And that's the reason I gave her the idol, to kind of symbolically represent, like, hey, this is how I want to play, and like, I want you to have this, and I want to show you that you can trust me. And Abby and I are sitting here together, you know, and yeah.
Thank you for your answer. So, the great Beyonce Knowles Carter told us who damn run this world, and she didn't lie. Honestly, I'm really honored to be in y'all's presence. And the reason why is I just go back to that merge tribal and that challenge right before it. And we're getting number after number wrong. And I really just remember during that tribal just looking around and being like, damn, I think we're the underdogs of this game. And so of the bottom six, three got voted out back to back, and the other three are here before me today. I really am just in awe that you guys rose to the occasion through all of that. And I love a good underdog story. So my first question is for Abby. It's very obvious that you played a great game in terms of getting immunities, touching all the idols. I feel like your social game was a little underrated.
Okay. Say more.
Yes. And so I understood you felt that you were potentially someone you could get voted out. Certain someone behind me, I've said, was a can that could be kicked down the road many times. So was that your only social game, or did you do anything else to add to that?
I think you're right. When people look at my game, they don't see it first and foremost as a social game. I mean, I've done some flashy stuff, like that is obvious. That being said, I would not be here if it weren't for you, if it weren't for Haley or Vivian. I certainly wouldn't be here if it weren't for either. Despite the fact that y'all thought I was the biggest snake in this game, I still had people who were voting with me into the moment. Even if y'all got like voted off one by one, I mean, you guys trusted me enough, and I'm grateful for that. You guys trusted me enough that I would vote with you. And I think that says something, even though I lied to you from day one. I was lying to everyone from day one, but I'm so grateful that I had people in the game that still trusted me. You guys weren't going to vote me off just immediately. And I think that speaks to the fact that I did play a social game, even if that's not really in the forefront of people's
minds. All right. Alan Haley. In my dying breath in this game, I hit up that Prima Gang chat, and I was like, manifest this final two. And I am so happy that my decision today is going to be very hard. So, I'm going to ask you two the same question. You're seated here with the Puppet Master. I know you guys pride yourself on your social game, but there are three words in the Survivor motto that I'm probably going to fuck up, so I'm not going to say it. So, how have you delivered on the other two? Valen, go first.
How did I outplay out with you?
Sure.
The Puppet Master?
Yeah, with regards to her, because I'm deciding between y'all.
Well, I guess, I mean, the Puppet Master touched every idol, I guess you could say that Abby did feel like she was a target throughout this merge. Like, you know, that was like, you know, she was mentioning it was like her pitch, like, oh, you can just vote me out for another round. But she did need those idols, and I never needed one. And that's where I think I would outwin, outplay, I guess specifically Abby, because I didn't need idols, I didn't need advantages, and I did this all by myself.
I only needed one.
You touched them all, but I didn't have to touch any of them.
I just wasted the rest of
them. Oh, okay, sorry. Yes, the question has been asked. It's obviously no secret that I think my strongest suit in this game was my social game. So it's like, okay, so how about the other two categories? And to that, I'd say that they were quite strong, but quite subtle. And I think that that speaks a lot to how I played this game and who I am in real life. I'm a Taurus. I'm bold. I'm bold, quiet, stubborn, grounded. And honestly, coming into this game,
I was absolutely naive because I had no idea all of the things that were happening and all of the relationships that people had and all of the connections that people had. I spent my whole life in this building, like 24/7. I knew nobody coming into this game. And so I'd say that my outwitting was being able to know exactly when and exactly who I needed to forge the relationships with in order to go far. And like Valen, I never needed to play an idol. I never needed an idol in this game, you know? I think Abby got through with the idols, right? But I was never at a tribal, like, getting through by the skin of my teeth, you know what I mean? Until this very last one.
Alright, thank you and congratulations again.
Auntie, first of all, I'm so glad to see you sitting up here.
Thank you.
Just so proud of you in general, and I'm so happy I got to meet you throughout this game. One thing I learned in this game is that perception is not reality, and reality is reality. And the reality is that you made it here, and that makes you as dangerous as the Puppet Master and as Haley sitting up here, so you should be proud of yourself. Amazing. One thing I really respect about you is you never needed the idols, you never needed the challenges to get to where you are, and you even had the first vote. Like, I think it speaks to your social game that literally Lauren, even though it was a fake idol, played one for you, and you knew about my idol, and when I told you that that idol was for you or me, that was 100% true. And I think that speaks to how good your bonds were, because you had me, you had Henry, you had Nadia, you even had Haley, and I think one fault of those two is that they didn't vote you at the final four, because that was their best move to do so. So props to you for that. I think one thing this jury wants to see from you is I talk about your strategic moves, the post-Renjin vote. For me, were you in control? Were you in a power position? Because the way I saw it in our six-person group that voted at the merge, you and Henry had all of that power. So tell the jury if that was true and if you had that power throughout the merge.
Yeah, I do think I was in a powerful position in the merge. I mean, people told me in the middle of the merge that I was on the bottom of the voting block, and they kept trying to get me to flip because they believed that the guys were really strong, that Xavier was controlling everyone and stuff like that. When I knew full well that I was definitely not in the bottom, I know we all had a great alliance, you, me, Henry, and Xavier, that I think really solidified my position in the merge. And that was a really important part of my game, was developing that alliance, because I knew I had a strong relationship with you, I knew I had a strong relationship with Henry, and I'm so happy to develop a strong one with Xavier, and I knew that those relationships were going to keep me safe, and I used it to keep you guys safe as well, because like, a lot of people did try to flip me to vote you guys out, and I made sure that I used the relationships I had in my merge, and during the merge, to keep me and my closest allies safe as much as I could. And post-run, you said strategic moves post-run, too?
Yes.
Well, I knew that Vivian had, we all voted that she was most likely to win Soul Survivor, and I voted for her in that question. And I also knew that Xavier played a really good social game. He played so well, and it hurt me to know that I had to vote him out eventually if I wanted to make it far in this game. That was the hardest thing I ever had to do, but I knew I had to do it, and I knew that if I wanted to make it far, I had to make a decision, and I just tried to make sure that me, myself, first and foremost, that I was safe every single time. I rambled a lot.
No, that was
even
a good answer. No, I answered it. And I have a question
so
for...
I would just say, yes, I do think...
Sorry, I said that you
were
done.
I just wanted to answer your question. Like, yes, I do think I was in a powerful position in the merge that people did not think I was in, but I was.
Okay.
Not
fine. Hi, Abby. First of all, congrats for getting here. Day 17, we had developed a really good bond on Verandi, and I was like, oh my god, I really want to have a bestie in this game. And I didn't know you had one at the time, but you were like, yes, let's be besties. And I think that started something, or so I thought, was something great. And that led to a lot of great memories that I really cherish about this game. We talked every single day of this game. We found two idols together. We did the whole AOL thing together. We even went drinking at Shinley Park at 1 a.m. And these were things that I really appreciated a lot. And then a few days before the Dark Round, we had an honest conversation in Hamburg Hall. And I felt like we were very vulnerable and very open about the game. It was very honest. And then when the Dark Round happened and you voted me, I was frankly just, we all know I was hurt. And it was very frustrating for me. And there's no way I can really describe it, but it felt grimy, to to say the least, because of how genuine we have been with each other this whole game. So given all of that, why do you deserve my vote tonight?
Can I be completely honest?
You can be completely honest.
You don't have to vote for me, and I don't know if you should. I mean, I'm gonna cry.
I don't want to cry also?
No! I am not proud of that. Like, I can say, looking back on it, that, like, it was good because I'm sitting here right now. I have my reasons for doing it. I mean, you had not voted with me the past two rounds. I knew that you were keeping me in. I trusted that you were going to keep me in. But I couldn't be at your whim that whole time. I needed to do something about it. And at the time, an hour before tribal, it sounded like the best move for me. Immediately afterwards, I regretted it. Like, if I could like regain your trust back and be sitting on the jury instead of sitting here, like, I would take that. And I hope that you know that. You know how I feel about it. I'm sorry it had to happen that way. I really am.
Oh, thank you.
My Black Widow Brigade! You made it. And I'm so happy to see all of you here. Honestly, we all did amazing, and I'm so proud of the games that all of you had, and congratulations to all three of you. You deserve this. Like, you all did what none of us could do, and that's why you're here. So congratulations to you all. One thing I want to address is that Valen, I love you, but you keep saying that you never needed any of the challenge wins. That doesn't mean you didn't try. I saw you playing your heart out. I saw all three of you playing your heart out. So not needing and not winning, to me, are different things. Abby, my homegirl, I don't actually have a question for you, but I do have a speech for everyone. Abby has grown so much since we first applied to this show. I'm definitely going to cry a lot. She has also never seen Survivor before applying to the show. She watched one season afterwards, saw Kageon, but she also came to this game not knowing what to expect, not really having seen that much Survivor. Starting from day one, right after the challenge, she started looking for the idol, and she realized after that was a mistake because people saw her, but she found the idol, and she went on to find all of the idols in this game, or be with people who found them. She knew at all times where all the idols were. She went from someone who was lamenting how badly she did in the first challenge and being so embarrassed of herself and just thinking that that was it for her, to winning three in a row to get to where she is today. Three in a row, that's more than any of us. She also, all three of you have actually been on the right side of the vote for the same amount for this whole merge. Additionally, Abby has only gotten 2 votes in the entire merge, and that's after coming in as the biggest threat when she was revealed as Puppet Master at the very first tribal. She literally was like, this is it for me again at the beginning of merge, and now she's here with having only gotten 2 votes that entire time. That's insane to me. Abby, I think you're too modest. Like, you have done so much in this game, and you have spent so much time in this game. Like, own it. I think that, like, the choices you've made were playing the game, and you've played the game very well. From the first tribal to now, you've grown so much. You've become a challenge threat, you've become an idol threat, you've become just a threat in general, being the Puppet Master. I know you were hesitant to do stuff with the Zaman idol when you first found it, and I'm glad that we did end up doing stuff together, because that only made you more impressive, and only made your spot here today more impressive. So I think you've grown a lot. I think you've really fought it out, and, like, I'm proud of your game, and I hope you are too. That's all I have to say.
Hello, everyone. How's it going? Valen.
Hi.
You played an incredible social game. Everyone knows that. Everyone saw it. And yes, you were in a power position for a lot of merge. But I want to know, because from where I was, it seems to me that it was you and Henry very close, doing a lot. I want to know what separates you from Henry, because it seems like Henry did a lot of the thinking, or not thinking, but strategizing, and I want to know if that's true, or and if you were just along for the ride, or if you came up with your own ideas.
So yeah, me and Henry were close throughout this whole merge, but I do think we played two different, we complemented each other in how we played in this merge. So he had ideas, and I had ideas, and then we had different ideas that complemented each other. So I don't think it was like all Henry and like I followed him, or that I was all, you know, what we were doing. And people, like, yeah, we were close, but I don't know if we were as controlling as people think
we were and how the votes were going, we just kind of had this like unspoken alliance and trust in each other, to the point where like some votes we didn't even have to talk that much to each other. We just had this like unspoken relationship and trust in each other. And I think there were, you know, some votes that he had ideas and we went along with them, and then there were some that I had ideas and we went along with him. So I really think it wasn't like I just followed along with Henry. We kind of just really worked together.
Hello, Puppet Master.
Hi. How's it going?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
Just great.
So speaking of Puppet Master, everyone knows that's a huge play. Like, great job. But tell me, do you think that being the Puppet Master was a good play, or do you regret it, or do you think it was not a good play because you were kind of doing damage control for a really long time?
I knew the location of every single idol for the entirety of the game, and a lot of that was because of the Puppet Master stuff. Like, I gave it to Nadia through that email so I would know. Well, first of all, Nadia, so that we could work together. That didn't work out. That's fine. Either way, I wanted to know who had those idols because I knew that information would be, like, beneficial to me. And it was, like, in that AL vote, once we figured out that, like, I was getting those votes instead of Ricky, thanks, Valen. It was my idea in that tribal to split the votes on AL and Nadia so that if she played her idol, which I knew that she would when I played mine, like, either one of them would go home. And I wouldn't have known that if the Puppet Master stuff hadn't happened. If I had just put that idol back, I wouldn't have known that, and that vote might have gone very differently. In the post-merge, when everyone figured out that I was the Puppet Master, like I said, I think that kept me safe. I mean, like, if I hadn't had that, if I hadn't had, like, the threat of me playing an idol, or, like, the fact that I was very easy to vote out later on, like, I don't think I would have made it this far.
Haley. You say that you didn't have any regrets throughout this game. But I remember a few times throughout that you wanted some votes to go a certain way and they didn't. Was that in the end, like, do you think that was bad for you? Or, like, how does it speak to that? Tell me, like,
A lot of votes didn't go the way that I wanted. You know, we started off our Dom's Alliance feeling strong. feeling strong, feeling confident. And a lot of times that confidence was in vain because things did not go the way that I wanted. However, I also chose to intentionally position myself underneath some of the biggest threats in this game. Being Vivian, being Abby, being Ricky, you know, being you, honestly. And so votes didn't always go my way, and we were blindsided a lot. But I think that if those votes didn't happen the way that they did, I could possibly not be sitting here right now. So in that case, I stand by what I said still. I have no regrets.
Alright. Thank you. Good answers, everyone.
To preface my questions first, I play this game very nonchalantly and chill, and many of you have acknowledged that. And tonight's a very serious night, obviously. All of you are nervous and have a lot of nervous energy. There's been even a few tears up here already. So in spirit of my game, and you know, to give you kind of a break, I'm just gonna ask some chill questions. just relaxing. So Abby, what do you think the most awkward tribal council was for you, and what were you the most scared of, you know, talking about coming into tonight?
The most awkward tribal council? Oh, I don't know if any of them were super awkward. I had some horrible voting confessionals. Well, that was one of
them.
for the Tina one, I said, I don't even know what to say. That was really bad. I mean, I thought I was getting voted out that round, so, like, that was why.
I think I said, the last time I voted Nadia, I said, can you imagine if this doesn't work? And it didn't work.
Same here.
I don't know about like awkward tribal councils. I had some bad answers as well, but I can't remember them. What was the second part of your question?
What was the one thing you were most scared to talk about coming into today's final tribal?
Scared to talk about?
Like, is there a topic that hasn't been touched upon that you were kind of nervous?
Oh, well, there's a topic that has been touched upon that I was kind of nervous about. I knew Ethan was going to ask me that. And I did not prepare an answer for it, and maybe I should have, but I don't know. I wanted to speak from the heart, so there was that. Obviously, it was like a hard thing to do, so I wasn't like, I don't know. It's not something I'm proud of, so I don't love talking about it, but it had to be said.
Alright, thank you
so much for your light question.
Good luck for today. I mean, I'm trying to start out.
Who's next?
Yeah, Haley. So coming into the tribal council that I got voted out, I was all confident, you know, I was like, I told Haley it was going to happen. And as soon as I came, I felt the air, I was like, fuck, I'm getting voted out. So like, you went to go talk to your confessional, and I heard some laughs, so I was like, yep, fuck, I'm definitely getting out. So I was wondering if you could share what you said in your confessional. Knowing that none of these answers affect my vote today.
Just for fun. All I said was Nikhil is exquisitely handsome and super charming. No. No, not that. I'm gonna stop talking. Okay. Sorry. Okay.
What'd you say, Haley?
Okay. Well, first of all, thank you for your question. Second of all, okay. So, basically, so we had a kind of like goofy conversation the night before, and I was just kind of confused and I didn't know what to do. So you said, if you have any questions, like let me know and I can, you know, hopefully like put you at ease or something like that. And I was like, wow, that's so businessy. So in my confessional, I held up your name and I said, so if you have any questions or concerns regarding why we voted you out tonight, just let me know and we'll get back to you in a couple days. All of my respect, Nikhil.
No, that was beautiful. I was just really curious ever since I heard, like, I don't know if it was Leo, like, cackling. Or, like, so I was like, I need to understand.
Like, that's charged language.
But yeah, thank you.
I'm going to ask all three of you the same question. Haley, I'm asking you first, so you're at a little bit of a disadvantage, but that gives you two time to think about it. So here's my question. No matter whether it was like a good strategic decision or what is your least favorite thing about both of their games?
Oh my. Personally, I wish Abby had told me more, because we worked together since day one, and like I said before, like I said before, like giving her the Dorit idol to like, you know, kind of take care of it, or trusting that she would tell me what she was gonna do with it, was so that she would trust me. And so I was hoping that she would trust me more during the game and tell me more information than she did. And I sort of kept finding out at like the last second or from other people and stuff, and then she would tell me. So yeah, that would probably be for Abby. This is hard. Because I love Valencia so much, and you hate me.
No!
I'm just crying, hugging you inside. For Valen, I wanted to work with her ever since like Joe got voted out, and I found out that they were friends. And for many, many votes, I wanted Valen to vote with us, and I wanted to get him to flip, and because I kept telling her, I want to make it to final three with you, I want to make it to final three with you, and I really never could, and you know, it was always sort of like, you were questioning me whether or not you wanted to, and yeah, that's probably that.
Okay, gotcha. You next.
Okay. I think, well, this is going to be boring, because it's the same thing about Valen's game. I think we were trying to get Valen to flip every single tribal. I mean, I've said this to a couple of people. I always talked to Valen before every tribal, and I always said, Valen, why don't you vote with us this round? And every time she said, maybe, and then she did not. Except for Nikhil, actually. I think that was the only one that we voted for. obviously, that ended up being the right decision for you. Like, that was a good thing to do, is stick with your guns and stick with those people. But it was very frustrating that you wanted, but that's what I chose. Haley, that's a harder question because I'm here a lot because you stuck with me this whole game, and I'm really thankful for that. I don't actually know what I would change about Haley's game or anything that I least like. I mean, something that was just like... something I was very upset about that happened that wasn't your fault was that I told Haley that I gave the Dorit idol to Vivian, and I hadn't told anyone else in the game at that point that that had happened. And I was super stressed out about it, telling her, and I don't know. You, how did that even happen? I don't remember. Why did I tell you?
Because I asked.
Because you asked. Okay, because you asked me, I would change that. I would have her not ask me that outright. that was very hard for me.
Well, for Haley, she kind of talked about this earlier. I wish she was more confident in her relationships because I do think that we both played similar social games where she had close relationships, and I like wish she followed through with some thoughts. You had some doubts with some people and some relationships that you had, and you followed along and, you know, with these votes and like almost, I don't want to say you were under a shadow, but like almost, like I feel like you had so much potential with, you know, how you played, because we played similarly, and I don't know, I like wish you went out more of your comfort zone, and I know people try to put me on where I was, but I think you were also in a position where you could have done that. And then Abby, what I personally least liked, I guess, I don't know, you talked a lot throughout this merge and this game that you weren't really good at challenges. I remember the day you won your first one, you said, why do I bother coming to challenges if I'm never going to win them? Then you went ahead and won 3 challenges in a row. And in all our calls, you said, I'm here for a good time, not a long time. Like you doubted yourself every single time, but I knew full well that you played a good game and you were going to play a good game. And like you had, you know, you were playing this game intensely, but came off a lot that you weren't. So I guess that kind of was, I don't know, own up to, I mean, you played a good game. And I just kind of wanted you to like, own it rather than...
That's super nice.
Well, in a way, like I wanted you to own, you know, the moves that you were doing. And every time you said, why do I bother coming to the challenges and stuff like that. So, I don't know, I just... You were playing a strong game.
That's
good.
First off, congrats you guys. Obviously, I obviously want to be sitting there with you guys, but you guys were amazing, and I love each and every one of you. I think, like, Val, we had a relationship since day one. Like, Abby, you were my biggest rival, but I mean, like I love you still, you know? Like, I think we're gonna be friends, we're gonna hang out after. And Haley, you know, we didn't really talk that much throughout the game, and I wish we did, but I think during the end, like, we really cultivated a good relationship, so I'm really happy for that. Okay, so first off, simple question for all of you. Abby, I'm gonna start with you. Did you come in wanting to win?
Did I come into this game wanting to win?
Yes.
Absolutely, I did.
Okay. Same question. Did you come in wanting to win?
I came in wanting to go far, and I got far, and I said I wanted to win.
Haley, same question. Did you come in wanting to win?
Yes, 100% yes.
Okay. So I'm gonna go back to Abby. You just said to me that you absolutely want to win, right? But during, when Ethan was up here, you said that you regretted that vote with Ethan, and that if you could go back in time, you would rather be on the jury than to like regain his trust, you know? So that's kind of contradicting, right? So sure. Do you really want to win, or was it more like, do you value regaining like people's trust? Like you can't have both, right? So what do you want?
That's an awfully good question. I think, like, I ended up playing this game much differently than I expected to. I mean, Prob will tell you, like, my first confessional was like, I don't think I'm gonna scheme, like, I don't think I can do that. Like, that's not the game I'm gonna play. Clearly, that turned out very differently. And I really thought that I was gonna be, I mean, kind of the opposite of Haley. I really thought that I was gonna be, like, very loyal, like, stick with people. I wasn't gonna backstab anyone because, like, that's this sort of person that I am in real life, that's the sort of person I want to be. But this being a game, I was sort of like, well, if I want to win, if I want to get far, I have to do things that, like, I would not at all be proud of doing in real life, you know? And, like, voting Ethan off was one of those things. And after that happened, I really looked back on it and I said, like, wow, like, this is just a game. And, like, I don't know if it was worth, like, losing Ethan's trust over that. And I'm glad that over the past couple weeks, like, we've kind of built that relationship back up, and I'm really, really grateful for that. But right after that vote, like, I was not sure that it was worth it at all.
Okay, Valen, I mean, I think, like, Aeol was my closest ally, right, throughout, like, pre-merge. And then after you got voted out, I, like, came to you, and you were, like, you knew that, like, I valued you as my closest ally. And I think you said in your intro that you didn't betray anyone. So my question is, did you or did you not try to betray me during the Henry vote?
Well, I didn't say I didn't betray anyone. I said I didn't need to. And I did vote for you in the Henry tribal, and it just came to the point that I knew someone from Zaman was going home, and thankfully I knew it wasn't going to be me. And in that, at that point in time, I was closer with Henry, and like that, just by like, it was just because of that. It wasn't, you know, it really just came down to that, and it did make me happy to write down your name. And that's why I tried to give you a chance in the next vote. Where I tied it so that you could have a chance of, you know, putting yourself here. I look out for you every time, for sure.
I remember something too. So I know that you told Ethan about my extra vote. So why did you do that?
He had my back, and him having my back meant he had your back, because, you know, we've been close from the beginning. I
Had Henry's back because of you.
I didn't know about that, by the way. I had no idea that was happening at all.
Okay. Can I ask one more? During the final four tribal deliberation, you know, like all of us were going back and forth in different people, and then there was one point where you were saying to me that, like, I think I convinced Abby to vote Valen. And then you went to go talk to Val again, right? So just walk me through that process of, like, I thought you were going to vote Valen because, you know, you had valid points. What made you change your mind, or was it because of Abby?
Oh, that was a...
Yeah, did
I
you...
I didn't. Have,
okay.
At all. Okay. No, that was a complete lie. I didn't. It was...
Good to know.
I told TJ this, like, right after, like, you know, that, like, I was like, I didn't lie as much as I wanted to because I felt so bad about it. But yeah, no, that, I did lie because I was trying to get your vote on Valen and off of me because I was afraid of a tie. And, you know.
Yeah. Finalists, jury, thank you for a good, great final tribal council. The jury will now be casting their votes to win. You are writing the person's name down that you would like to win. Runjan, we will begin with you.
Girl, I'm so fucking proud of you and the way you played. Your social bonds have been amazing, and I'm so glad I got to meet you this game. Love you so much, girl. Best of luck. Queen.
I know this seems like an obvious vote, but you truly, truly deserve it.
For the last time this season, I will go tally the votes. I have the votes. As a reminder, you are looking to see your name on the pieces of paper. You will need 4 votes to win. For the last time this season, I will read the votes. First vote. Valen. That's 1 vote, Valen. Next vote. Haley. That's 1 vote, Haley. 1 vote, Valen. Abby, that's 1 vote Haley, 1 vote Valen, 1 vote Abby, 5 votes left. Abby, that's 2 votes Abby, 1 vote Valen, 1 vote Haley. Valen. That's 2 votes, Valen. That's 2 votes, Valen. 2 votes, Abby. 1 vote, Haley. 3 votes left. Abby. That's 3 votes, Abby. 2 votes, Valen. 1 vote, Haley. And the winner. Scotty Survivor Lost in Time. Abby.
Yes, happy master.
Abby, congratulations by a vote of 5-2-1. You have become the second winner of Scotty Survivor and the winner of the $500 grand prize. Absolutely.
Yeah, keep
I don't have anything to say, just thank you guys so much. This has been like awesome to play with you guys, and like I couldn't be more honored like to be here. So thank you so much.
To everybody who played Scotty Survivor this season, from the bottom of our hearts, it has been an absolute pleasure hosting you, watching you play. This was an incredible season from start to finish, and you all should be so proud of the way you played. I can't wait for everybody to see it. And just thank you so much.